So a key to staying on top in Siege is innovation.
You just got to keep trying to evolve constantly.
Tem que inovar muito, porque senão você acaba sendo jogador muito manjado, né? Então você tem que procurar sempre essa evolução.
So the meta in Siege is constantly changing, right? That's probably the best part.
There's always new operators implemented. Depending on what they bring to the table, they can definitely shake things up.
Ubisoft a voulu mettre en place un renouvellement trimestriel pour que le jeu soit vu et abordé d'une nouvelle façon par les joueurs. C'est une adaptation constante et un renouvellement des strates constant aussi.
Chaque saison, des nouveaux challenges, que ce soit en termes de compétition, en termes de stratégie, on veut toujours être les meilleurs.
Every team in Siege, every region, kind of has their own playstyle, so it's important to figure out what the new meta will be and then add your own twist to it.
Estou inovando, jogando com os operadores novos e mostrando coisas que podem ser feitas até mesmo na Pro League, entendeu? Quanto mais você joga, mais você fica acostumado com coisas novas e não é tão surpreendido assim quando você vai jogar um campeonato. Às vezes você pode até surpreender seus adversários, né?
There's basically two types of teams, the trendsetters, right, who kind of figure out what it's going to be and start setting up sites with the new meta. And then there's teams who kind of wait, watch VODs, and then put their own twist on something that's already been discovered.
You really do just have to go into each season with a new mindset and not be stubborn, be willing to try to learn from other teams.
I really want to see how this Ying plays into this push.
40 seconds to go.
With the most recent operation, we saw Ying come in extremely strong, and Ying put in a lot of changes into the meta.
He's going to blind them tremendously. He's going to go down for the push, go for the play, right under the drop patch.
She also forced out Oregon as a map, which now Oregon is one of our top two most played map.
One that really comes to mind for me is like the introduction of Mira, who kind of took every map and recreated how bomb sites were defended.
Au début du jeu, on avait tendance à fermer le bomb site, à renforcer les murs. En tant que défenseur, on ne voyait pas ce qui se passait de l'autre côté. Maintenant, on peut mettre un miroir qui allonge la ligne de vue. Ça va être maîtriser encore une plus grande partie de la map et étendre les défenses.
On border, the armory lockers defense, people do a monitor's mirror where it looks down the hallway. It's probably the strongest way to hold the bomb site.
Et ça se trouve, on découvrira encore des nouvelles choses avec ces persos ou avec même les persos des premières saisons dans un an parce qu'il y aura des nouvelles maps, parce qu'on approchera la map différemment.
We all have the skill. We can always grind the hours it takes to stay on top. What it comes down to is the determination to win, being humble in defeat, like always learning.
Plus ça va aller, plus il va y avoir de maps, plus il va y avoir de stratégie, plus il va y avoir de bombes sites, et plus ce jeu-là, il va nous rendre fous, mais fous dans le bon sens.
Destruction in Rainbow Six Siege is probably one of the most influential things in every round.
It's basically limitless. There's an infinite amount of ways a map can be played through destruction.
Adaptation, stratégie, destruction, tout ça, c'est Rainbow Six Siege.
We first have to focus on whether it's going to be like defense-sided or attack-sided destruction. When you're playing attack, you think of destruction as opening up the defense's setup.
On va essayer en fait de trouver la faille de l'adversaire. On va essayer de discerner rapidement un mur ou une ligne qu'on pourrait ouvrir pour aller les sortir de là, leur dire écoutez, nous on veut rentrer ici, donc il va falloir partir maintenant. Ça va être notre contrôle et ça va être notre possession.
From a defense standpoint, we focus on the most efficient way to hold a bomb site.
Most of the time on defense in Siege, it's just you're just trying to stay alive. You're just trying to wait out the round. What you'll often see the attackers do is try to force you out of your safe space, your safe location, and then try to catch you in a rotation to another spot or just kill you in the spot that you're in right now.
Eu acho que outro diferencial desse jogo é isso, né? Você poder quebrar tipo teto em cima do jogador que está embaixo. Tipo, o jogador está defendendo o bomb. Ele acha que ele está safe, mas não, o teto em cima dele quebra e dá pixel para você matar ele. Então isso entra o conhecimento de mapa, você saber onde quebrar para tirar aquele pro seu oponente daquela posição para você efetuar o plant.
Um defensor pode avoir une défense en béton armé, mais ça se trouve un seul trou va pouvoir lui détruire toute sa défense parce qu'il pourra plus jouer dans sa zone de confort. Ce trou-là, cet endroit-là, c'est le trou qui va faire la différence sur la stratégie.
En strat, on s'amuse à détruire les murs et à se découvrir des lignes. Il y a des lignes qui apparaissent aujourd'hui sur des maps qui datent de la première saison. On travaille nos stratégies comme des chorégraphies. C'est-à-dire que tant que chaque pas, chaque temps n'est pas respecté, on ne la mettra pas en place en match. Tout doit être maîtrisé. C'est pas nos stratégies de base qu'on va envoyer en Pro League, c'est nos stratégies en fonction de l'adversaire qu'on va avoir en face de nous. Et du coup, ça va être préparé, renforcer des murs ou détruire des murs qu'on ne fait pas d'habitude, mais qu'on va préparer par rapport à leur stratégie à eux.
Personne n'aborde la map de la même façon, personne n'aborde la game de la même façon, personne n'aborde le round de la même façon, personne n'aborde le même bomb site de la même façon. Tout le monde a une vision de jeu différente.
C'est de la connaissance de la map, du jeu et de l'adversaire.
A trophy defense on Chalet and the attackers have established control above trophy and kitchen, then they have so much pushing power to just come in from wherever they want. They can enter in through the west lobby, they can enter in through the main lobby with almost no contention if they've got a buck or a sledge opening holes above.
Là, à partir de ce moment-là, une fois qu'ils défendent plus dedans, c'est tellement un espace restreint, c'en est fini de la défense.
When I personally think of destruction, I think of different angles I can throw my smoke grenades. The angles, for example, on Oregon, playing in closet behind a mirror and denying a plant on laundry machine or the bins behind that is very practical and safe, and most teams actually do that right now.
What you should do if you want to get onto the Pro League level as a player is find yourself on a team, practice with that team regularly, establish a baseline of a strategy, take that strategy and go against other teams and try to figure out what was wrong with that strategy and develop upon it. You just got to keep trying to evolve constantly. And again, it just takes hard work and perseverance.